Right.
ठीक है, तो आई जस्ट मेंशन इट एज सीसी।
Hello, good evening, and a very, very, very happy new year to each one of you. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you to the interview series of Mentor My Board, that's Boardroom Talk, in the new year 2021 with fresh energies, fresh learnings, and fresh talks with eminent directors and the professionals like CEOs, CFOs, company secretaries of corporate India and international boardrooms we bring to you. And with this interview series, we would be sharing the best practices followed by these professionals in the boardroom. So let me introduce Mentor My Board to you. Mentor My Board is a platform where corporate directors come together to learn, to network, to sharpen their boardroom skills and get opportunity of serving on the companies to act as directors, women directors, independent directors. And most importantly, we are on a mission to create a community of 1 lakh directors by 2027, and promoter directors of SMEs, MSMEs has been a major focus for in the areas of governance, business, finance, marketing, strategy at the board level. So we help directors who continuously are looking to sharpen their boardroom skills, leadership skills, and upgrade their knowledge on better governance through best board practices, which help the companies they serve on to grow faster ethically. So let me tell you, we have been recently conducting these Boardroom Talk series, and we have been getting wonderful response from you, feedback from you. Thank you for liking this series, and surely we will be bringing the eminent directors before you with their immense experience sharing, and which is going to help you as directors. Kindly do share, like, subscribe our Facebook page, LinkedIn page, Mentor My Board, our YouTube channel, Mentor My Board, and most importantly, join the community of Circle of Directors on the platform of Mentor My Board. The membership is very much open. We have close to 200 people already on the platform with 35 mentors on the platform. And that's something very, very unique community which is built up and growing. So today I, CS Divya Momaya, founder of Mentor My Board, invite our esteemed moderator, CS Bharti Iyer, who has rich 30 years of insurance industry experience, and she's an eminent advisor to Mentor My Board. So let's get ready for the boardroom talk today with Sudha Bhushan. And I request Bharti to introduce Sudha to all of us. Sudha has been our esteemed member of the platform Mentor My Board, and we are indeed very, very happy to have these wonderful interactions with you, Sudha, today. Welcome. Over to you, Bharti.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Welcome, Sudha. A wonderful new year to you. There have been a number of memes, you know, about 2020, but I must say for me personally, except for some few tragic losses, it's been a wonderful year. And I hope that 2021 is going to be a very joyous, prosperous new year to all the viewers and you, Sudha and Divya. I would love to, go over the profile in detail, Sudha. So please bear with me because I know you're very modest, but please, because it's a wonderful profile. Sudha is a chartered accountant, a company secretary, a professional insolvency regulation professional, a registered valuer, and also an independent woman director registered with the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. She's well reputed as a finance professional, advising a lot of companies as a capacity of advisor. Sudha maintains a public profile of a well-known speaker, having spoken in more than 500 seminars organized by various institutes in India. Amongst the global thought leaders in foreign direct investments, she has been called to share her thoughts in international fora like Horasis Asia Meet, etc. She's very well connected with Indian trade chambers and presently is the co-chairperson of Business Next Committee of the reputed Indian Merchant Chamber. She's also very well connected with a number of international trade organizations. Sudha is a planner, an executor, a developer, opportunity seeker, and a relationship builder. Sudha is also a co-founder of the Taxpert Professionals, a multifaceted consulting company. She is advisor to the Bank of Baroda, NRI, and international operations of the Bank of Baroda, and is empaneled with HDFC Bank as an advisor and trainer to their capital account transactions department. She's also presently an independent director with Aurionpro Solutions Limited, Indian listed companies like FinQuest Financial Solutions, and systemically important NBFCs like DIGJAM Limited, Indian listed companies, and Matix Fertilizers and Chemicals Limited, which is an Indian unlisted company. Sudha is an expert in the Indian FDI, foreign direct investment policy, FEMA and valuations, she has been working in this area for more than 15 years. She has authored the following books on foreign direct investment, Foreign Exchange Management Act 1999, and international taxation. There are a number of books, foremost amongst which are International Transactions, the Comprehensive Review, which is published by CCH, Due Diligence under the FEMA, published by CCH, Comprehensive Guide to FEMA, and Practical Guide to FEMA, a practical aspect of FDI in Indian companies, published by the Institute of Company Secretaries of India, our alma mater, a handbook on FEMA, published by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, handbook on international taxation, publication of Institute of Company Secretaries of India. So there is a co-chairman of Business Environment Committee of Indian Merchant Chamber, the ladies wing. She is a member of the Indo-French Chamber of Commerce and Industry. She has been a member of a committee of International Taxation of WIRC, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. And she's a member on the editorial committee of WIRC of the CA Institute and the Committee of Women Empowerment. Sudha has also a number of other interests because she's an advisor to multinational companies, including Fortune 50 companies like Hitachi and CRH PLC on the international transactions. She has more than 2 decades of experience in audit, FEMA, international transactions advisory, structuring and regulatory affairs, and India's investment policy. Sudha's experience is gained by extensive working with international firms, where she has started her career with Deloitte, then moved on to a German consulting firm, and then to an Indian investment banking arm of an Irish company. Wow. She has extensive experience of handling business transactions from initial public offers to FDI, and she also advises corporates and PSUs as well as government authorities in a lot of intricate transactions. We will skip to the last paragraph because this is something which I'm also very, associated with very much. A scholar throughout her life, she has been awarded many awards and recognitions, including the Women Empowerment through the CA Professions by Northern India Regional Council of the CA Institute. Okay. Sudha is a noted speaker and has addressed various national and international fora like Forasis Meet, and her articles are regularly published in the journals of several institutes like IMC, ICAI. She is also a visiting faculty to various prestigious business schools like the Kohinoor Business School, the NMIMS, etc. Welcome, Sudha. It's our privilege to have you here. And on this nice and lovely occasion of the new year. So let us get started on your journey as a director. From a professional in a corporate consulting firm like Deloitte, then to starting your own company and then becoming a director on various boards.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Adivya. Thank you, Bharti, for inviting me. And I am privileged to be invited on your wonderful platform. And you've been doing a very, very good work.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I wish you all the best. And Bharti, thank you for my very long intro that you had to read. Thank you for that. Yeah.
Achievements are so many, Sudha. So it's
absolutely. I'm going to ask you one thing later in the discussion. So please go ahead.
Yeah. So I'll start with my professional journey. So my professional journey, it had been the journey of chasing my passion. So it has been very usual, like all other Indian women. So I was born in a family after my 3 elder brothers. And my dadi said, oh, ladki ho gayi. So it's like it's like the same way every other lady in India starts their journey. But I think with the forward thinking of my parents, and especially my mother, I could manage to study. And it was like, for me, it was like I was not allowed to go to coaching classes. So I used to go one before my school and one after my school, so that, in the pretext of that, I'm going to school. And so that no one comes to know. So this was bit about my journey in the way it started. And post that, then I scored very a good percentage in 12th standard. So I got the admission in a prestigious college in Delhi. And so everyone there, a few of my friends were doing company secretary. So I thought that, okay, I will also do the company secretary. I did the company secretary along with my graduation. And after graduation, a few of my friends were doing CA. So I thought I will also do the CA. So I also did the CA. So it had been like this. I mean, it's not that something was very specific to be done, but it fell in place and I got it right.
So it's not always being at the right moment at the right time, Sudha. It's what you have been working behind the scenes, which may not be so well, patent to others, but that has brought about that synchronicity. You know, you could have also got into CA and CS and then flunked and left it. And then just got married and been a housewife, you know. So that is not it. It is that you managed to do it and with shining colors. And then you have gone on to excel. So which brings me, I'm sure Divya is also very keen to know because she's an author herself. So which brings me to the next question. How did you manage to write so many books? And some of them are the go-to books, reference books. Okay, and then which is your favorite?
Yeah. So regarding the books, it's like, I think necessity is the invention. I mean, necessity gives rise to invention. And I, as you would have seen, my career had been with the MNC only. So I started with Deloitte, then, you know, a German consulting firm, then Irish consulting, not exactly consulting, but investment banking. So what happened that this, we were dealing with a transaction wherein this foreign, this company wanted to invest in India. And it was a huge transaction, a 1500 crore transaction. So this money had to come and they were waiting that, I mean, the money had to come, but the condition subject to condition precedent. So both the parties agreed, but the condition subject to condition precedent, it had to come. Now we were looking at the solution that how can we execute this transaction wherein it meets the purpose of investor also and investee also. I could not find even a single book. I could not find even a single book on FEMA. And luckily I got this circular that, okay, you can maintain a escrow account and all. So we got the solution, but that triggered my mind that there is no reference book on FEMA. So that's where I got that okay, I'll write a book myself and I'll refer that book. And God was on my side. Then in 2013, I got this idea and then I got my pregnancy leaves that time. I used my pregnancy leaves for writing this book. And as my son got born and the book also got born, my first book in 2013.
Absolutely fantastic. I mean, usually, you know, that's the time every woman feels that this is the time I need to give to my, you know, child. And bas wahi focus hota hai. Uske alawa, I don't think people really think beyond. But that time you utilize for writing a book, wow. I mean, that's something wonderful.
And not just any book. Just see the technical book. It's a go-to reference book. So I guess that is why you are saying that is your favorite book also, Sudha?
No. So my favorite book came in January 2019. That's a comprehensive review of international transaction. You know, we have been dealing with MNC and we know that the people who are sitting outside India, they have no clue. They have no clue about Indian regulations. And the CFOs who can be from any background, not necessarily from accounting or a finance background or law background or regulation background. So that the thought came to me that why not write a book which can refer, which is easy and it can be referred by CFOs of the MNC company. So that at least these four things that I talk about in that company, so that is taken care of and any international transaction is sorted. So I've tried to bring it in the fashion that it is good reference point for the CFOs and all the other professionals as well. So that was released in BSC and it was released by a lot of eminent people. So that's my favorite book.
Wow.
Sudha, I would like to, you know, just request you that on the platform of Mentor My Board, we are helping all our mentors, facilitating the availability of your books on the platform for the members of the platform. So I would, you know, really get in touch with you that separately, and we would be happy to have your books on the platform.
Certainly, certainly. Yes. My pleasure.
Thank you. Yes, over to you, Bharti.
Yes, absolutely. So in your experience, I know, what do you feel that amongst this valuation and so many other qualifications you have, do you feel that you would be amongst the very few who are having so many technical qualifications? The finance?
Definitely. I think in India, CA and first of all, let me pay my respect to my profession, CA and CS. As in, it's the most easy profession that a lady, that a woman can do. You don't have to go out and you can easily do it. So if a person like me can acquire this qualification, anyone can do it. And so definitely, yes, but that I'll be few because also these new professions that have come, like registered valuer, IRP. So these are the new professions. So ladies are getting into it, but maybe I am one of the 10 ladies, finance professionals will have this, all these degrees right now.
Absolutely
wonderful to have you.
It's really unique. And that too in the space of MNC, you know, that's what I was telling. Today also I was reading is the season of the IPO is coming up. And a lot of people are looking at India. What has been your professional journey like in terms of, you know, It has landed you the role of independent directors on both companies which are in the middle of some financial trouble, plus thriving companies. So what has your professional journey been like that, you know, you have landed here like this? What are the specific highlights you feel can be mentioned for the viewers, which you feel has, you know, been turning points in your professional career?
Yeah, so I can tell you my... So I had been very clear about 2-3 things. I'll take it one by one. Yeah. One is that while I was with Big Four, I've always worked with international companies. So while I was with these companies, it was like that, okay, if I give 10 to 12 years of my life to them or 10 to 15 years of my life to them, I'll reach the top. There is absolutely no question about it that I will not reach the top. But will I be making myself completely worthy? As in, will I be doing what I want? And will I be making myself useful to the society to the full of my potential? So I realized that no, I will not be doing it. So I quit it. I quit at the juncture wherein I think I was earning very, very good. I was at the very good position in my that company. So I quit that, and then I started with, I joined my husband with Taxpert professionals, and from there, it has been a journey of learning every day and making impact in, okay, we are not a very big MNC or we are not a very big company employing 1,000 people, but definitely whatever we are doing is making, adding value to our clients. And to the employees that we have, I not call the employees, but the team members that we are bringing in together. That's how. And the way, if you ask regarding the independent director, how I got into it, I think, Bharti, for a finance professional, it is little easy to get into the role of independent director. If it is a financial a professional or a company secretary, because you know you are aware of the environment, you know what to expect, and you are already working in that sphere. So one of my friend was handling the IPO. They are acting like a lead manager for them. So they had approached me, and that's how I landed up in my first independent directorship. But I have stories to tell you. I tell you how it went for me and what all mistakes I made and what all learnings I had from that.
Yeah, but a few of them were more enlightened, because that's why we wanted to have a slightly different type of boardroom talk series today, more on the human interest angle. You know, so if you feel you can share, and you don't need to name the company's names, But if you feel that something is there which the viewers will be very interested and benefited by, please share.
Yeah, I can. So I can share so what exactly? I mean, so if you can maybe, okay, I can tell you my experiences from Boardroom. I'll tell you my first experience of the Boardroom. So I read every detail about the company, whatever possible. I read every detail. I learned their employees' name as well. It was such a detail that I prepared myself. Right. And in the first board meeting, I went like stern, you know, like, why this is not happening? No, this is, change the auditors. They are there already for 3 years. Who is the company secretary? Where is the compliance report? And this and that. And I actually made everyone look like what is she trying to achieve out of, you know, all this, all this knowledge that she's showing off. So that was my first Boardroom interaction wherein the lesson that I learned from there, that you have to be ease with the directors. You can't see them as the culprit who are doing the wrong things. They are the one who have nurtured the company. They are the one who love the business the most. So you have to be a facilitator. And it comes with the time. As in, once you are inducted, once you know the company, you will know where you can add value. So that's how you learn. That's how you add value. So that's where one of my experience had been, that wonderful awkward experience that I had.
Yeah. A learning experience. Now you can think back and laugh over it.
Absolutely. Now the boardrooms are different. The way we handle the boardrooms and the pleasure and happiness that we derive by bringing in the value. And the comfort that comes with the directors also. Okay, that these are the facilitators, these are the learned board members, independent directors, who will bring on their own domain of knowledge on the table. So that's how it's a process that I am also evolving and everyone does evolve.
That's there. But I think what would have facilitated, Sudha, you don't promote yourself. You don't push yourself forward. So I'm sure that particular a character trait of yours would have come in a lot useful. A lot of people who, with your qualifications and the type of achievements which I just now read out, they have this thing of throwing their weight around, which, because you're pretty young also, so that is what would have facilitated you, I'm pretty sure. So great that you are sharing this knowledge.
Yeah. So Bharti, there was this directorship that I had held. They are an absolutely promoter driven company, and the moment, in fact, that's they would not even acknowledge the presence. It was purely that, okay, the women director is required, she's sitting there, thank you, that's all. And then in transaction, I was fine. I mean, till the time everything is happening in order, you don't bother the directors also, it's okay. Besides that, you don't speak in the board. You don't speak in the board. Apart from that, they will take care of everything. Your conveyance, your comfort, but you be silent in the board. Don't speak. So that happens. But then a transaction came up in that company with regard to the buying of land from the promoter at the price which was not at arm's length. So I communicated with all other independent directors, took them in confidence. Although the transaction did went through, but we made it a point that we have our recordings in the minutes. So that's how we handled it.
Very nice. So you managed to do the corporate governance at the same time, ensure that the promoter was also, very confident and, it was conveniently done. But at the same time, you made it a point to ensure corporate governance.
Because sometimes, what happens that the promoter, they don't realize that we are not here to, we are not the authority, we are not the government, we are not the income tax officer. We are just independent director. It is on them to derive value from us.
Yeah.
If they take us as the watchdogs, they won't be able to derive value. So we will put our things forward. We got got that minuted, we will put our thing forward. So more on companies also to derive values.
Too right. So Divya, you wanted to ask something, I am sure.
Yes.
Very quirky expression you have.
yes, absolutely. I mean, the experience what you shared about the boardroom and as independent director is really so, you know, connecting. And I think most of the Indian independent directors have been in this dilemma, have been in this kind of situation, I think one or the other time, because in India, we have been dealing or we have been living in a corporate world wherein almost 90% of businesses are promoter driven. And promoters have their own interest because it's their own baby. But at the same time, you know, keeping independent directors informed about the transactions and taking their help as the, you know, enablers and not the hindrance makers is very, very important. What, you know, I think the promoters need to change their mindset to. So
absolutely. I can tell you. So two of the board, in fact, I would like to name them. So Bike Hospitality is one board and the board of Aurionpro. I can tell you it's such a professional driven board. They are so much ahead of the curve in the way they see the role of independent directors. They will involve in every strategic decision. They will involve for even the smallest of decision, there are presentations to be made. And there is not even a single, you know, meeting which is not preceded by the proper management information report. So that's, they are the board that you really, you know, you feel that, okay, they are the actual user of the position of independent director and you feel happy and you, so for example, Aurionpro, they are into the automation. They do banking solutions, automation, and they are into cybersecurity. So they are doing very well. And there is one business in Singapore like AFC, that is automated fare collection, for which they are looking for strategic partnerships. So they bring forth the proposal and we are working there absolutely as a team. So that's very, so lot of learnings from them that we get. We are also able to incorporate the good learnings from their way of doing things and the learnings that we are giving to them. So both ways, it's very good.
Wow, very good.
So actually, when you collaborate along with the board, no, it feels so good that you're adding value. You're also growing as an individual. When the board, they make you stretch. And when you stretch, you get your fullest potential. You know, you grow.
Definitely.
So this type of collaboration is a real win-win for everyone, you know. You don't compete and you work as a collective unit for the growth of the company. The best way for shareholders' wealth maximization.
Absolutely. Yeah. So what happened in this board of Bike Hospitality? What they did, they work from 16 location in India. They are into hotel business. I always call, because I use hospitality, I always end up calling it as hospital. No, it's a very good veg restaurant or veg hotel that they are maintaining from 16 location in India. What they did, they arranged the tour for their location for the independent director. They made us meet all their employees and they asked the suggestions. And suggestions in the sense, the suggestions, tough suggestions that, okay, whether the suggestions which will never be, you know, bring forth to the board, like whether we should expand to the outside India or, you know, they bring forth they asked us the suggestions and their tour was at the cost of the company. And they were not only that they asked, whatever suggestions that we gave them that you should, you know, invoke some competition between the different hotels, you should invoke the best employee concepts and so many others, every suggestion got implemented. So that's on the board. That's on the board. Other usi jagah par board ye soch raha tha ki okay traveling cost lagega ye independent director ka ya kuch karenge nahi. So you know all that is their mindset.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Deriving the best possible values, really worthwhile. So we will just move a little bit to the viewers who are watching, because I don't know whether you record from the chat or the groups, a number of people are so excited, Sudha, that you are talking today to MentorMyBoard, you know. So a lot of them have asked, like, what do you feel? What have you got to say for young professionals who are aspiring to be directors or who are already young directors? What do you feel that they should look at when they're invited to be a director? What are the questions you can answer in your own way?
Yeah, yeah. So for the young directors, I'll say two things. First of all, independent director is not a position. It's not a revenue earning source. It's a responsibility. So you have to be, I mean, a young professional who is looking to be independent director, they have to be very clear in the objective. It is not a fancy position. It can actually bring you to a lot of liability. There is a hell lot of a liability, and whether that liability is commensurate with the professional sitting fees that you are getting, one has to evaluate that. So one has to be excited about the company and look at the thing that whether you will be able to add value. If you are able to do that, then certainly then start building on the profile. So when I say building on the profile, it doesn't mean that the next thing that you do is to start sending good morning messages to everyone on earth on WhatsApp. It is bringing on the meaningful visibility of your qualities to the public forum in a meaningful manner. Meaningful will mean here that it should be beneficial. It should be beneficial in whatever domain that you're working. It cannot be harping on your qualities. It has to be bringing on some value to some sphere of people. Like if I'm a chartered accountant, what value am I bringing to the profession? If you are a doctor, what value can you bring to the pharmaceutical company? So those values has to be put forth. So building on profile is very, very important. That should be worked on, but building on meaningful profile, that's very essential. And one of the myth that Bharti and Divya, that I have seen that people have, that you really need to have a very big degree. So, okay, I completely agree. As I stated that Chinese professional do have an edge. That's an obvious reason, because finance is a function which every business organization has by default. However, you have an HR function also. You have an operation functional or function also. So depending on your area of expertise, you can add value in that sphere and then present yourself as an independent director, your profile as an independent director. However, building on your profile and being able to bring something useful on table is very essential.
Very nice. Very nice. Especially for the young professionals and then who are already independent directors, independent women directors, young independent directors who own startups. What would you say to them as what are the top qualifications they should acquire? Not in terms of technical qualifications, in terms of, you know, for giving the maximum value. Like suppose you're, like you said, you're a doctor and you want to be an effective independent director. So what would be the top three things, like financial literacy, cybersecurity, things like that?
First thing will be being ethical, bringing ethicalness to the table. Very, very essential. And I am very sorry to say this, that ethics, I mean, I'm really sorry, but then ethics are not taught. Ethics are not taught especially to us. Ethics had no value till the time Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is a very good example. Abhi Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, if it was not there, what we did? We threw our garbage on the road. Similarly, we can see the ethics in the boardroom, ethics in the company. They are not taught to us. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, jab tak nahi aaya tha, jab tak fine nahi lag raha tha. Nobody bothered. Similarly, ethics is something which nobody penalizes. That's why there are no ethics. I mean, I'm not saying that's why there are no ethics, but that's why ethics is not given the importance that it should be given. So ethics is the first thing that one has to bring forth and incorporate as a culture, that there will be no bribery, there will be no partiality, there will be no nepotism. So these are the things that one has to bring on table to the board. And especially for women director, if you ask me, Bharti, it will be women-centric issues, maternity leaves, and your POSH compliance or POSH, very, very relevant, very relevant. If I don't speak about the POSH, who else will? Yes. Because what happens, you know, it's on the paper, committee ban gayi, theek hai, presiding officer ban gaya, but no one is, whether actually it is being implemented, actually whether the women out there are getting benefited. So some of these things we can, you know, bring in.
Well said, very well said. Yadavya, you want to ask something?
Yeah, one thing I wanted to ask you, Sudha, was about somebody was telling me that there is nepotism in the boardrooms also. So have you come across something like that, some such incidents wherein, I mean, the some companies have fixed kind of, you know, the independent directors rotating from here and there and new people are not able to get in those positions. Anywhere you've come across such kind of situation?
I mean, you and me know that there are few board positions which no matter who you become, you will not get. So that's there. That's there. Your qualification, I mean, it's just, okay. So there are few positions that you will not get. That's for sure. And you should, I mean, it's a written thing. So yeah, there is, I have not come across. I thought that so I have not come across personally, but we all know that.
Correct. True. Thank you for that. And over to you, Bharti.
So I just wanted to ask you, like, specifically corporate governance in SMEs, MSMEs, family startups, what do you find is the difference between that and, you know, large corporates? And do you feel that there is a very huge gap from the benchmark standards for little bit of corporate governance standards, which they can use, you know, in that SME group itself? And do you feel that that gap can be bridged anytime soon?
See, when we talk about large corporates, there are specific teams working on corporate governance. There are specific, segments that are taking care of it. Okay. Vis-a-vis SME, the most a predominant problem of SME is finance, is its money. It's hard earned and it cannot spend on anything. So they have to be very, very cost analysis, cost benefit analysis in case of SME is very, very rigorous. That's how I think there is a gap in the corporate governance between the two. However, if you ask me, it is not about big and small. It is about who you want to be. A good SME, an SME can also be we have seen SMEs with a very good corporate governance and a very good corporate, very large corporates with no corporate governance. So it is about the company. So I don't remember the name. So this person, he spoke with me once that every company also have vibes, like human have vibes. Like if I meet you, you will get vibes. So every company also have vibes. Like Infosys will give you different vibe. Reliance will give you completely different vibes. So that's a culture that gets incorporated and built over a period of time. And that comes from the top management. What's the culture for your firm that you are setting? Wow. Whether it's a high standard or it's just anything. That okay, ye bhi kar lo, wo bhi kar lo, fake certificate le lo. Balance sheet mein high value dikha do, bad debt mat dikhao. So, you know, what's the standard? And that comes from the top management. So more of the differentiating factor is not whether it is SME or whether it is large corporate. It's about the mindset of the top management. If it is very well educated, it's nurtured well, then I think it really plays a lot of role in the whole gamut of business.
Yeah, as three of us being company secretaries, you know, that artificial entity concept, literally, you know, said it's maybe artificial, but it's a living, breathing, organism. And it has its own ethos. That ethos comes from the top, how you build in that inherent spirit into the company. So whether it's a small company or large company, yeah, like you said, the whole vibes and the ethos of an Infosys, a homegrown company like Infosys, or if you have ITC, you know, so different it is going to be.
Absolutely. But,
yeah, you can always grow into it. It's a wonderful thing. I think you might think about another book on this.
Regarding SME, you know, Bharti, I'll tell you one thing. That is what we have experienced. The SME have two problems which they should always address since the time they are growing up. What happens, you know, with SMEs? From 25, they go to 50, and from 50, suddenly they become 200. They don't know what to do. From 200, they will grow 500 because somehow their business model clicks and they don't know what to do. So two things that we have identified for SMEs are taking care of their inheritance. India ke andar sabse bada problem jo hai, SME big corporate nahi ban pate hain. That is because they do not plan their inheritance. If there are two sons, it will get split up. So if they can plan up their inheritance well in time of their growing up, they will very quickly grow up to a large corporate. And the second thing is their working capital management. Most of them, they will think, okay, employing a professional is a waste. Their money goes waste. They don't employ a professional. They want to do everything by themselves. So that's where they lack. And if they use the expertise of the professionals, or you know, they bring in, they buy the minds of people, they can grow very fast. That's
very, very regulated and structured manner they can grow, correct?
Yes. क्या होता है ये ये जो promoters होते हैं, they want to do everything themselves. So that if they can, you know, shelve off some money. I know their cost benefit analysis is rigorous and but agar thoda paisa deke they can gain that expertise. That really helps them.
So now we are almost you know, the last 10 minutes, and you told me that you have a hard stop at 40 minutes. So I just wanted to ask you on a totally different tangent. You know, you are into cycling in a big way. So how did you come on to this? How long have you been doing it? And yesterday you achieved 100 kilometers, you know, in a single bike ride. So I'm really amazed. So tell us a little about that, Sudha.
Yeah. Thank you so much. I'm glad that you're asking me this because I am very, very passionate about cycling.
And just to add on what Bharti asked, I want to ask you, women usually complain, oh my God, time nahi hai. So after writing so many books, after, you know, being on boards, after being a professional, after being an insolvency professional, after being a registered valuer, how do you manage to get time to pursue your passion? Continue, please.
No, I think... All of us have become expert in managing the time. However, what I do is doing one thing at a time. So be in the moment. That's my, that set in my mind that be in the moment. So half an hour, if you're given to something, let that half an hour be given to only that thing. Otherwise, there are so many things that you will not be able to do. And then very important is two more things that no, saying no to irrelevant things. If it is not relevant, so one has to have a long-term objective, and everything around your ecosystem has to fall in place with that long-term objective. If it is not falling in that place with that long-term objective, you have to cut it short. And nevertheless, there are a few things which are most important than anything else, like your kids. For a lady, for a woman, for a mother, it's a most important thing. So that's a long-term objective that that always run on a different tangent, always.
Absolutely.
So I was talking about my cycling thing. So I did this 100 kilometer benchmark yesterday. And so I started around two years back, wherein we started like 20 kilometers, 30 kilometers. And then yesterday I did 100 kilometer for the first time. And all two, three things that I think I can... draw from here is good company. So good company is very, very important. So I got this very good friends who motivated me. And at the end, like day before yesterday, I was not sure whether I'll be able to do 100 kilometers or not. So I have this friend, Shefali. She said, no, you can do it. And then she pushed me. So right people in your life are very, they play a very important factor. And initial 10 kilometers, I think it was a very tough. My mind was again and again telling me, no, Sudha, wapis kar le, nahi ho paega. Nahi ho paega, you go back. You won't be able to do it. But then again, I pushed. I said, okay, let me try. And then when I reached 50, it was a cakewalk. then reaching a target was the only thing that, okay, I want to do it. So I think that was also, setting a target was also one of the important thing that plays an important role. But yeah, I mean, and it relieves of the stress and rejuvenates a lot.
True, we can see it on you today. And I think that is the story of your life. No, that's what you have been doing. Initial starting inertia se leke wo movement karna thoda dhakka lagana hai. Uske baad you have managed to achieve all these things, no? One by one. So I think the cycling is just a representative example.
Yeah.
Sudha, just wanted to ask you, like, what did you think of MentorMyBoard specifically? What is, in your opinion, the USP? What do you feel like MentorMyBoard can do in terms of coaching and mentoring people who are coachable, but for them, what do you feel? And boards, from your opinion of other boards, MNC boards, what do you feel in all these aspects?
I think it's doing a wonderful job. That goes without saying, and the attraction that it is getting, the right kind of people that are getting attached and that are getting associated with the MentorMyBoard is it itself speaks a lot about it. And I think the USP will be the passion that you guys have. Looking into Divya's passion, your passion, it's amazing. It's contagious. You know, a morning you see, "Arey Divya to utke kar bhi diya." I mean, you know, that's a really very good. And the concept in itself, you see, there is a gap, right? It's something that you are serving the larger purpose. And if the board gets educated, the whole education flows down to the company. And if our company becomes good, our economy will definitely become good. So educating the board is a very, very good task. And I think, you know, it's not that we didn't have these type of platforms, but those were, I think they were a bit more not getting touched by the people. MentorMyBoard is touching the right kind of people and bringing in the tailor-made products. Maybe because you are professionals yourself, you sit on board yourself, you know the gaps, so you are able to fill them. So I think it's doing a very good job. And the USP is passion of your people.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Yeah, because I've been seeing Divya's passion, you know, and both you guys are like that. So I'm very thankful to be associated with both of you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, so Divya, you want to, end with our New Year's message to Sudha herself, and then, you know, invite her and
Thank you so much for wonderful interactions, Bharti and Sudha. You know, there are so many learnings which, you know, as personally me as director, as a business owner, you know, have got from today's interactions with Sudha. And again, yes, there are a lot of things where as a professional, I think we must groom on. And Sudha, I would be really happy to have you as esteemed mentor on the platform of MentorMyBoard to, you know, guide the SMEs, MSMEs on your expert areas, that's international taxation and the transfer pricings and the FEMA regulations. And again, most important, being a woman, you know, in a boardroom. So huge, huge task when I see, you know, what all things we can do. So I would be really happy to have support of you as a mentor on the platform. And that will really add value to us as the platform. At the same time, we will make sure that it's a win-win model for everyone who joins the platform, whether it is directors, whether it is mentors, or whether it is corporates who are joining in. So I would be really happy to have you with us on that. And I'm sure, you know, the way we have been talking, the way we have been working, we will have a long way, you know, in taking the corporate leadership in the boards to the next level. So thank you so much for being here with us today. And let me tell you, let me tell the viewers here today, let me wish a very happy new year 2021 to all of you. Let me tell you, the platform is up and running. The memberships are going on. We have around community of already 180 odd people joined the platform. 35 odd mentors are there on the platform. So please do come and, there are N number of things which are happening. And 2021, again, as I said, is with new hope, new opportunities. and most importantly, new learnings for all of us as directors. So do join the platform, Circle of Directors. Do like, share, subscribe the pages, the Facebook page, the LinkedIn page. Keep sharing, keep viewing, and keep contributing in terms of your expectation, your knowledge, and how you can contribute. So thank you everyone for watching this series. And I know you keep watching it even after a week. So if you have anything to add on, anything, any questions specifically for our guest director mentor for today, please do post to us on our email IDs or on any of our channels. So thank you, Sudha, from the bottom of my heart. I know it was 1st of Jan and just told you and you agreed in spite of your busy schedule. So thank you for being here with us. So any closing remarks from you about your experience today? So that will be wonderful.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Divya, and thank you, Bharti. Thank you for inviting me to be a mentor on the board. I'll be happy to be there. And wishing everyone a very happy new year. It's a new year eve, and I hope that 2021 brings more happiness. I mean, it's not like 2020, which has been a very, very sad year for a lot of people. And wishing you very, very good luck. And
Thank you.
Very enjoyable day. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
On the 1st of January.
Thank you.
But last but not the least, let me tell our viewers, very soon we will be starting the series on the platform of MentorMyBoard with our esteemed mentors on various topics. So stay connected on the platform, and I'm sure that will be immense learnings for your boardrooms and for you as directors. So thank you, and keep viewing and keep watching this space. Thank you.
Thank you.
So thank you.